Got the 250 unloaded this morning. We had to side unload it in the street way up there. Walk it down here on fire hoses. Got two mats there and two mats over here. So, I guess the fun is about to begin. Got the pond down a lot. I'm gonna come over here and dig a creek channel on the far side to get the water away from this bank and get some of this mud laid up on the side to dry out, because I'm gonna leave the machine sitting right here so we can load out the trucks. I just gotta be careful. There's a sewer line that crosses right up through here. There's the manhole right up there. I'm just gonna try to get all that mud piled up over here and the creek channel moved over there, and then lay all that mud up against the bank over there. So, let's get started.
Number one. and sit a couple mats here and get that a little bit better than that. Just really want to ditch over here, but I want to try to grade it as I go. We're only shooting for about 3 to 4 feet deep. make a good dredging machine though. It is too heavy. Oh, I'm going down. Thank you. me trying to get out of here though.
I'm getting that laid back over there. I'm sitting on mats. It's still a little deep, but at least there's solid ground below it. It's not too bad. I'm gonna keep digging this creek channel back and turn all that water loose up there. Try to keep the machine clean.
So I'm gonna come up here and clean some of that out, but keep in mind that bucket's 6 feet tall. At least 8 feet deep right there. So I'm gonna hold off on that for right now. I'm gonna dig a little ditch to let this water out, and we'll just have to dig some material out before I can venture up there. Thank you. getting that water cut down like 3 feet should really help dry it out though.
Thank you. I got everything laid over there that I could. At least the creek is over here now, and the water will drain down that side, and that mud should dry out a little bit. We'll haul it off and make more room for more. So we got the lake down a good 5 or 6 feet. The 6-inch siphon is cut off, but the 3's still running, and it's not very deep out there, and it's still a couple days before it's going to rain, so I'm going to turn it off. We don't need to have a fish kill out here. It is summertime and the water is warm, so they need all the water they can get. So I'm going to turn that off, and we'll just have to start it back up after the rain, because this thing will fill back up instantly. As you can tell, the overflows. A lot of watershed. All right, let me get this opened up. Start sucking air and cut itself off. Big gush. That's it. Don't suck no more.